Got the three screws in place, that'll turn nice. Next thing to do is connect them to the different axes. So we're going to use the hardware label 13B and C. Okay, with the two 13Cs in place, you don't have to get them real tight at this point because we're going to match them up with the nuts. So slide it up to the nut. And it would be a good idea to put the nut as close to the end as possible so that it's as accurate as possible in its placement. In other words, the screw can flux more out here than it can over here. So this is a better position to work at. So we have to get this one out of the way. And for the ball nuts to the brackets, we use 10-24, 1 1/4, 4 per nut. And a lock washer and a nut. So once that's installed, we can rotate it, make sure it turns freely, and it does. So go ahead and tighten this one up. These can be locked in place with some thread lock later. Next, I'm going to sneak up on the other side by turning the screw and holding the nut until it just comes in contact, and I'll add the four screws to this side. Alright, that puts the table lead screws on the gantry. Now you want to make sure that it's square before we start running it. And the best way to check for squareness is put a tape measure on it and compare it to the other side. We got 12 3/4. It's perfect. Within a few thousandths. So you want to do better than that. You certainly can by cutting a test square and just tweaking one screw with the other, and you get it right on. Next, we're going to put the gantry lead screw onto the Z. And we do that with 13B1. It's got two milled surfaces, so we have a right angle. That right angle needs to be between here and the back plate 19 of the Z. So I'm going to put the 13B1 in place with the milled side against 19 and the milled side on the edge here towards this bracket, using the hardware that came in the bag for 13B. The longer screws are going to go all the way through into the bracket, and the shorter screws are going to come through 19. So we're going to need to move the slide down to get to the first screw. And in fact, I do believe you want to put the head of the screw on the inside, nut in the back. Don't want to get it tight at this point because we're going to get everything aligned based on the nut in close proximity to gantry plate 18. Okay, 13B is loosely in place, and I've got the longer screws going through the body, and I'm going to slide it up and match it with 13. Okay, so plate 13 is now in place. It's just held on loosely. I'm going to slide it over to the end where I've got this nut, and it's missing a grease nipple. I'll go ahead and install that now. Grease nipple to the outside. And we'll screw that nut up to the bracket. And install the hardware. Now the nut, the head of the screw works best along the body into the flange of the ball nut. and the nut on the opposite side. Snuggle up a little bit and then turn the screw. That will help put everything in place. Then I'll go ahead and tighten up the brackets. Okay, all that's tightened up. Now we'll give it a test. Turn the screw and everything turns freely. So, we're doing good. All we have to do now is add the back plate. Then we can put the motors on, connect it to the controller, and start making stuff. So the back plate is fastened with this bag of hardware. These are called Z nuts. They're going to fit into those T slots and they turn 90 degrees and locks in. There's enough hardware here for the back plate and the polycarbonate sides. Pre-installing by putting on the hardware but not tight, just a couple of turns. Put this in place. There we go. Line it up with the ends of the linear rail and tighten it up. Alright, next we'll put on the motors. Here's the motors, they're going to come pre-wired, so all you have to do is put them on the machine and plug them into the control box. wires are going to come to this corner, because this is going to be X0, Y0. So our energy chains are on this side, the X motor, the Z motor is going to come this way, and all the wires are going to come to this corner of the machine. So we're going to use these motor mounts, and this hardware bag. These are 1024 by 3 inch sockets. With the Z, we'll bring it down to this end to make it a little bit easier. If you like, you can use a drill. Energy chains in place. They're going to come with the hardware in place, so all you have to do is just put them in the T-track and tighten it up. Now with these energy chains, they've got a hook on one end and a hinge on the other. So we're going to pry them up. You want to make sure that you're prying the hook and swinging on the hinge. All right, with the energy chain all opened up, we put a motor in. We'll be able to fasten this up here. Run our wires through to this end. And we'll get this other energy chain in place. Now we'll open this up and put some motors on.